A smaller delta t makes Euler's method more accurate. And we can see why. The reason Euler's method is inaccurate is that we're pretending that a constantly changing rate is actually constant over some time interval. Over a time interval of 2 minutes, that rate might change quite a bit. But the rate will change less if the time interval is smaller. So if the time interval is 1 minute instead of two, the bit of make-believe where we pretend that the rate isn't changing will be closer to reality. And I can illustrate that on this next plot. So I won't go through all the numerics of this, but here is Euler's method for two different delta t's. So first, the squares, which we've already seen, we calculated those before, that's Euler's method with a delta t of 2, where we're pretending that a constantly changing rate is actually constant for a whole 2 minutes. Delta t of 1, that's the triangles with the dashed and not dotted line. It's a little hard to see, but the key thing is it's between these two. It's closer to the exact solution, which is the solid curve. It's closer because the ignoring of the problem is a less bad thing to do. We're pretending now that a continually changing rate is only constant for 1 minute instead of two. So it's not as much of a lie. And by now, you can probably guess how we could make this better and better and better. We would let delta t get smaller and smaller and smaller, and then we would see that the Euler method would be exactly on top of this line. Now that we've seen part of a particular example, let me talk about Euler's method a bit more generally. Euler's method applies to differential equations of this form. A differential equation is a dynamical system, a rule for how something changes in time. What makes differential equations a little bit tricky is that the rule is indirect. This tells us how the derivative changes, and we're interested in how the quantity x itself changes. Euler's method is just a way to go from this indirect information derivative to the direct information about x. So Euler's method converts this indirect rule, the differential equation, an indirect rule involving the derivative, the rate of change, and it converts that into values for x. It does so by pretending that this rate of change is constant over a time interval. So Euler's method does this conversion by pretending that the derivative, which is constantly changing, is actually constant over some time interval delta t. This bit of make-believe gets better, closer to the true value, as delta t gets smaller. So as delta t, our time interval over which we're pretending the rate isn't changing, as delta t gets closer and closer to zero, this Euler pretending will get less and less wrong. And in this way, Euler's method, a solution obtained from Euler's method, will get closer and closer to the true answer. So as delta t gets closer and closer to zero, a solution obtained via Euler's method will get closer and closer to the exact solution. So Euler's method is a computational way of finding a solution to a differential equation. It requires doing a computation, and you can see that as delta t gets smaller and smaller, the computation will get longer and longer. You'll need to do more and more steps to get anywhere. So these are almost always done on a computer. So this is an algorithmic solution to a differential equation. It's a procedure, it's well-defined. For well-defined differential equations, it's guaranteed to converge to the exact solution. So Euler's method is very general. It almost always works. And I think it gets at the core idea of a differential equation. A differential equation is a dynamical system, a rule for how something changes. The rule is a little bit indirect because it is in terms of the derivative, the rate of change of this quantity x, and not x itself. But Euler's method is a little bit of a trick that converts this indirect information about the derivative into direct information about values for x.